Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Oh, well, welcome back from the show. That was Florence anyway. She was trying to take a picture with celebrities, of course. She went off that show. Right now in the studios, we have the CEO, KCCA.
Why is she looking at me?
Anisha Mohoz, welcome on the show.
Thank you.
We've been longing to have you on the show.
I'm finally here.
After chasing for a year now. Yes, that is the truth. For a year. It is.
It's been a year. Yeah.
Welcome. This is Sportswoman.
Welcome.
Yes. Tell us about Anisha. Who is Anisha?
Anisha Shai Mohozi is CEO of KCCA Football Club. I'm a mother of two. Two girls. I have girls. Yeah, mother of two. What else do you need to know aside
from that? Married?
Yes, very, very married.
Okay. Yeah. How did Anisha come into office? We've seen a few ladies in this position, in this kind of administration. Everyone, when you were appointed, everyone was like, how did she come? Why Anisha?
It's been an interesting journey. I didn't start off as a CEO. I joined the club in December 2017. I came in as an operations and administration manager. That's where I had my... my basic skills and everything. So I started off as an operations and admin manager. So when an opportunity came, when the former CEO, Josephine, resigned, I had been around, and I think the board saw it fit that I would take the club to the next level. And I was appointed on an interim basis for 6 months. Then I think I proved myself, and then here we are today.
Okay. You know, it's hard to work with men, ladies working with men, it's kind of hard. So how have you managed to work in a male-dominated field?
I can't say it's easy. it's been, it's not been easy, it's been a journey, and especially me, with my background, I came when I was not around the sport at all. I hadn't been around the sport at all, as I'm a former banker. I was in the bank before I came to the football club. So there was a lot of criticism. She doesn't know the game. How can she come and take the club to the next level? So there was a lot of bias, aside being a woman, but also the fact that I hadn't been exposed to the industry. So it's been a journey. It's still a journey. I can't say that I have achieved it all. But slowly by slowly, I've tried to learn and adjust. Sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some, but it's still a journey. I think African world, or even world over, they haven't appreciated the fact that women can actually, they can actually take over certain things and actually do them well. There's still that stereotype amongst women. But slowly by slowly, it's the women that are there. It's the task that we have to do to prove, to show that we can be different. We can actually do things that even men, because when a woman is there, they can actually do certain things better than men, because we have other attributes that come by just the virtue of being a woman.
Because at home, you're a mother at the same time.
Yes.
You have to go and also manage home, and then also have to manage your husband, and then the next day work like that. So it becomes
easy,
right?
No. It's not easy, but at least it teaches you. If you've managed a home, running a home is equally not easy. And that's why you see that there are certain professions, when they find out that someone is not married or something, they actually don't even give you a job, because they know that there are certain attributes, or there are certain values, there are certain things you haven't experienced, and it would be very hard for you to actually, because an organization is pretty much the same. You have people that work, you have those that don't work, you have these a myriad of everything, so you have to know how do you integrate between the two.
Okay, people judging you that you've not been in the field, and maybe having conceptions whether you will work or not, how do you rate yourself? Like, mm-hmm. how would you rate yourself ever since you joined, ever since you took on the job as CEO?
On a rate of, on a scale of?
Yes.
One to ten? And is it on a scale of 1 to 10? Mm-hmm. Personally, when I took over the job, I set personal targets for myself. As an individual outside of the organization targets that were set for me, I have my own personal targets that I set for myself. And I'm saying I've not yet achieved them. So in line with my personal targets and what I think I need to do at the football club, I've not yet got there. But largely on the overview, sometimes I sit back and I wonder, oh, how have I been able to actually do it? How was I able to integrate and mingle? And because at least now I have a better perspective of the industry, I have a better perspective of the whole environment and what entails it. And sometimes I take a step back and I think, oh, how have I been able to get where I am? How have I been able to actually do it? So on a scale of 1 to 10, I would say I am at 7%. And the 3% are some things that are outside my control. Mm-hmm. There's quite a lot that I would want to see happen at the football club, taking it to the next level and everything. But unfortunately, I am inhibited by a number of factors. So 7 is pretty good. But in terms of my personal targets, I would say I'm still midway. I'm not yet there. I'm still midway in my personal targets. And yes, I will.
As a CEO, there's been a lot of challenges, like you quite mentioned it here, though you've not told us what some of the challenges were, but someone could read. What do you think has made the club, because you'd love to call it an historical club, if you look at its performance at the continental level, basically if you talk about continental football in the country, you'd only talk about two clubs, that is KCC and Sports Club Villa. And yes, that is the bigger fact as a journalist. Now I'm not talking as a fan. There are only two clubs. You talk about KCC and Sports Club Villa. What do you think has been some of those challenges within your way that has actually made the club not go far, probably at the continental level that you would think should have been? Yes, because your slogan is more than just a club.
Yeah, more than just a club. And I think we have demonstrated that almost every other day, the things we do. Not so many clubs even in the region do them. They're actually just trying to play catch up. We have been able to do things that other clubs are not able to do. And we are happy, but we are not yet there. So some, to answer your question, some of the challenges, there were quite a number of factors that affected us not reaching at the group stages. Some of them are technical, some of them are financial. It's a whole basket of issues that culminated, one culminated into another. And at the end of it all, we've not been able to get there. But we have done the evaluation. I'm happy to say that we normally do evaluations. Every time we face a challenge, we sit back as a team and we evaluate and we see what could have gone wrong, what should have been done right. You know what I mean? How do we move forward? And like I said, there were technical issues, there were financial challenges.
Was it choosing players wrongly? Or probably overbearing on young players?
No. We won CECAFA with the young lads.
Oh, we're talking about continental
Champions
League now.
Do you know the clubs that were playing CECAFA? The likes of TP Mazembe, Green Eagles, and those are the same clubs that actually play in the Champions League. Mm-hmm. And if you look at the teams that we were actually competing with, I can't say that they were better than us. They were just, like the manager likes to say, they were just able to put their chances, they were able to utilize the chances that came their way. We could have been there. We had all it takes. We just needed to have a fair result at Lugogo. But like I said, we had certain challenges, like especially on the technical side. Some factors were out of our control. We bought players, we couldn't use them for the first round.
Sure.
And largely because some of them, there were players that had played in different countries, and there was supposed to be
ITC,
what we call an ITC release.
And
by the time the ITC got released, the CAF window had already closed. Mm. So we had Amari, but we couldn't use it. We couldn't fire it, and we couldn't use it.
Was it a miscalculation?
No, because we, at some point, yes, but not entirely. The game is football, and one thing that I have learned outside of the other fields that I have been in, it's very, very volatile. Football is very volatile. First and foremost, a player agreeing to your terms and agreeing to put pen to paper is not necessarily a clear-cut process. No. Today you will agree, tomorrow Villa comes, yeah. Poaches, the other one, and we have a vice that is common. We have the agents that yes. confuse the players and promise them heaven on earth, which
so
is
you,
not there. So,
initially, you want to say that probably the agents have contributed something to our failure at the continent?
No, it's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is we had a number of factors that could have. We have a number of factors, not could have. We have a number of factors that caused us not to have gone to the group stages. And like I say, one of them is technical,
yeah.
the other is financial. But we've taken back, we've evaluated. And I will tell you that for the next Champions League, there are certain mistakes we can't repeat. Mm-hmm. There are certain things we cannot.
Especially
we had improved.
Why are we not winning away games?
We had improved.
Yes,
if you look, if you look at our statistics, prior we used to concede
yes.
so many, but in this run, we actually conceded only a few goals. Okay, so there is an improvement. But you see, you are dealing with human beings and. You sometimes cannot control the result.
You
may have everything that it takes.
Do you give them enough probably take home? Because this one, I would love to be a little bit honest to you. You know, footballers are very funny. And one, this person will never stand on the court to protect footballers for such reasons that I know best, that I happen to be into management like you. Some of the players, actually, who even left the club, who are not with the club anymore, kept on saying probably their allowances to Champions League, where cut off. If probably you were supposed to give in, for example, if they were supposed to be given $100, you only to find out that someone is telling you you're going to earn only $50. Do you think it is something that probably contributed to it, or it was just an allegation coming out of anger from some of those players?
No, I don't think it was ever about money. Even the bad run that we had, it was never about money, because when we looked back, it was never about money. But just to answer what the allegations were, at the club we have a bonus policy
yes.
that was signed by the board, and this bonus policy was communicated to the players even last year of when they were still in the Champions League and Confederation last year. It was communicated to them, how much do you earn and at what level. If you're in the Champions League, obviously the per diem is much more than when you are in the Confederation. And it's simple. It's simple math that it's largely because of what the Champions League is able to give you
yes.
if you qualify to the group stages, and what the Confederation Cup can give you. So the players were actually taken through the bonus policy of the club, that this is how much you get when you're in Champions League, this is how much you get in Confederations. But one thing that I've also learned, that players sometimes need to be reminded, constant reminders every other now and then.
Do they sign a contract?
So that
binding policy?
Yes.
And in any case, for someone who jeopardizes it, what do you do to them? Because
we have,
jeopardizes the name of the club.
Yeah, we have now, some of those, like I said, the allegations that came at that time were not the per diem.
Yes.
It was actually SECAFA money. It was SECAFA prize monies. We won SECAFA in July.
Yes.
And SECAFA only sent the money in, I think, October, November.
Yes.
I forget about that time. But that allegation happened between there. So the SECAFA monies hadn't been received. The players hadn't got the prize money, because we obviously only pay as and when we receive. So some of the players thought maybe the monies had come and they hadn't been given to them. But we kept on having constant engagements with them.
Yeah.
But players will always be players at some point.
Anisha, is it true that Kasozi has been phased out because he one time demanded for money, for his pay?
That's something that I'm hearing for the first time.
You've never
said.
Heard about it?
No, phased out in terms of what of him.
He's not given playing time.
I've heard the rumors.
Because he demanded for money.
That is not correct.
It is not correct.
At KCCFC, we don't, I mean, how? The manager, we all know the manager that we are talking about. It's always and always about performance.
Is he in discipline?
No.
Because at some point I remember Kasozi.
He's doing well on the national team.
Could it be in discipline?
No.
Because
Kasozi,
you see, I am
not
one person who doesn't like covering for players. If it is bad, let's say players are in discipline and that is it. That's why when people were protecting Salim Jamal, I stood out and said, no, guys, much as we are talking about his issue of money and what, but have you also looked at the repercussions of his actions? So, you know, players are used to be pampered like babies.
I hate using that word. Players are babies. I hate
why
using
do
we, that word.
Do you have
but no, I will come out boldly and say Kasozi is not indisciplined. And it's not that there was any issue of him demanding for money and what. No. That
so
is not a picture. It's largely performance based.
So
in it's
how
either
he's performing well. And
you,
he
see,
was
you see,
wasn't
the, you see, what is it called? The game or whatever. It depends on the philosophy of the coach. What does he want to achieve at the end of the game? What does he and how does he achieve it? So if Coach A says, for me, I will use this formation and then I get this result. Coach B will say, no, I can't use that. For me, I will use so and so and so. So at the end of the day, the technical team takes charge of that. And I don't want to say there's been that allegation that he's not liked by the coach when you say it. That is not the case. Mm-hmm. It's all about, and I don't want to say it's performance. At the end of the day, it's what
the coach
wants. Yes, he wants to, he knows. Why do I play Kasozi and I don't play this? Mm-hmm. Maybe because Kasozi plays a certain way and he doesn't want that for the game that he's putting up.
Okay, Anisha, let me talk about Allan Okello before
yeah.
we...
Becky, before you go to Allan Okello, mm-hmm. having talked about the coach, let's summarize it here.
Mm.
KCC was supposed to travel up country to go and play.
Mm.
Was it West Nile? The game that you lost?
Mbarra City,
yes, to Western Uganda. And there was this report that the coach reported late, and actually he was waited all along. He turned so late until the bus had to leave him. And this, to our disappointment, the club we're talking about lost a game in Mbarra, and some people attribute the loss to absence of Coach Mike Mutebi. We well know Mike Mutebi, who he is and what he has contributed to KCCA. And the kind of publicity gave to the club, do you think you as KCCA has something better to offer? Do you think that KCCA, Mutebi is taking KCCA now for granted, that probably he is now a child in the home, no one can say he's a bull in the crowd?
No, I don't think so. I don't think that is the case. It's true that the team traveled without the coach to Mbarara, and it is true that we lost the game. However, I don't want to say that we lost the game because Mutebi wasn't around.
Did he come late?
yes, he did come late. He did come late. We had a time that the team was supposed to leave, and obviously we couldn't wait and make the entire team delay. So the bus had to proceed without him.
There was no
him.
Way for the coach to catch up to the team.
Exactly.
Now that is that was. But yeah, just to probably there's. An assertion that you put that the game was lost because Mutebi wasn't on the touchline.
We've also
lost games when Mutebi is on the touchline.
But you know he's a superstar.
And we know that Mbarara has always been a boogie side for us. So we went in knowing what was at stake. But maybe if he was there, maybe things would have been differently. But those are lessons. Again, we pick lessons.
Anisha, I'll take
you
back to Okello's deal that he had, the one that was offering you guys 800,000 euros. Then you wanted 800 and they were giving you 500. When you went for trials, then they were offering 350. What happened? What went sour? Because there is a rumor that maybe that is why Okello has been frustrated all along, because he wasn't, you know, given that chance.
Okello is frustrated. I'm not understanding.
Yes,
there is a rumor
that he's frustrated.
But I think Okello has had the best performance ever since he came back from Zurich.
Really?
If you look at the statistics, yes, Okello was on form when he came back from Zurich. And to just answer that rumor that was there, we don't deal with hearsay, okay? The agents speak quite a lot. They will say there's a deal of 300,000, there's a deal of 400,000. But at the end of the day, nothing is brought. We only and only react to communication that comes from the club and it is written. Either it is a letter that is sent through email or something. But hearsay, we don't react. And I will come and I will tell you, to date, we have never received a formal offer from Zurich. Yes. So if there's anyone that is saying there's an amount, the club didn't agree, it's all hearsay because no formal communication ever came from Zurich.
Now that their contracts are about to expire in January, what are your plans?
Who says their contracts are expiring in January? They're not expiring in January.
Really?
The boys are still with us.
They've extended?
No, we haven't extended as yet, but the boys are still players of the club up to their contract expired the other year. We were only acting a bit early. The things that were there, because we like to plan early. We don't like to wait for the last minute. Then we start running around. Are you renewing? Are you not? Yeah. It's always better you engage early. So the boys still have, on the even on the old contract, they still have a year to go.
Anisha,
a year and some months to go.
While we're on the subject of transfers and all that, what do you have to say about KCCA's transfer policy? The club, I don't know whether it's they actively try not to retain players. Like, over a period of 5 years, you've gone through quite a number of players. What do you really say about KCC and the retention policy?
Yeah. As a club, we would like to retain the players. But the players, sometimes you can't retain them because of the forces of demand and supply.
Mm.
One, if a player gets an offer, and many a times the agents will first go to the player and tell him, oh, Becky, we need you. There's a club in, so they need you. They will offer you this much and this much and this much before they actually come to the club. So by the time they come to the club, they have already gotten a buy-in with the player. Mm-hmm. Now, if a player has been promised better, because we know that in Uganda, we are the club that pays the best, okay? But I know that even what
probably,
we pay...
But there are players also earn better.
No. Locally?
For me, I would disagree with you. It depends on the bargaining power of the players.
Locally.
Because we have players who are earning much money.
Locally, Adong. I know that we pay better, and our money is every other month. It will
what
come.
Is that your money
fine.
Is
you
timely.
Can prove me. You
if
can prove me
timely,
wrong. You can prove me wrong on that. But I know that
your money is timely. Yes,
we have that.
KCCA pays better than any other club,
as far as I know. As far as my research, anyway. Let me just
then
correct it. As far as my
crying.
Research, would do they leave to? do they leave from KCCA to go to a local club because of better pay?
No.
Because of but then they say.
Yes.
No, that is rumors, and rumors happens in this business. But anyway, I just wanted to tell you, you also have to appreciate why do we sell as a club? People will ask, why does the club sell? The club sells because we have to make money, not even making money. We have to meet our expenses. The club currently has a budget, we have a budget of 5.8 billion. But out of that, 30% comes from the institution. And earlier on, you were telling me, that, oh, KCC has a lot of money, they give you a lot of money, but they cannot fund the entire budget. They only give us 30% of the budget. So the 70%, we have to look for the funds. We have to generate the funds. Now, if you feature in CAF, playing in CAF is not a simple game. Just a simple CAF game. Even with, I'll tell you, over this run, the three games that we played, we spent over 600 million. And that is with the Federation even coming in and giving us 25. tickets. So where does that 600 million come from? This is money that you sink in, and if you don't qualify to go to the group stages, you don't recoup any of it. Like now, we put in 600 million and it all, we didn't get anything back. So how does a club survive? So you find that sometimes it is inevitable.
Yeah.
We actually have to sell. But we are cautious that also we need to retain. We need to retain the players. But like I mentioned, aside from the club having to sell to make money, sometimes it's beyond us. If a player has got an offer, say maybe he's going to get $3,000.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, no club here can offer $3,000 currently every month. So you cannot retain such a player if he has already been sold out into going out. So sometimes it's out of our hands. A player
okay,
wants to leave.
Before we wind up, how are you handling Godemwango's issue, and what should we expect from KCCA in the next round?
Ah, okay. Odumengo, he's out on bail. He came out of bail, so he will continue. The police investigations are still going on. We will support him, and we have supported him in as much as things. He's still under investigation, so we will wait
still
to see.
We will still wait
until the court finds him guilty, but we are supporting him in the best way that we can.
Does he still continue training, in any case, if there's a training?
He just came out, so we have training. He's going to resume training. He passed by to the at the club. Next round, what we are looking for, of course, you know, we are number two in the table. So everything that the club is going to be doing is going to be aimed at being number one, because for us, that is our number one goal. We have to be the champions, nothing less of that.
For me,
so every effort is going to be pushed into gaining
just
that.
I'd love to kind of add just
okay.
a second, because I thought she was leaving. Is she still around?
No, she's leaving.
Okay, before she leaves, just a kind reminder. We are kindly requesting as a media officer, as journalist, sorry, try as much as possible to put people who understand the media at the gate. I was quite not very happy one time how a bouncer was responding to a senior journalist in this country. I mean, even if you don't want someone to enter, even if they don't have an ID, I think there's a proper way you can communicate than trashing somebody up. And then two, probably someone is caught up, and then because KCC has a crucial game, and yet we need to report these games to TV and what, because our role is to grow our own game in Uganda. Because I make no sense to talk about Arsenal or Manchester, but I make more sense if I promote KCC here. So our kind request to you, probably try as much as possible to put people who understand communications at the gate.
So like maybe just to get clarity, someone comes when they have a card and they are bounced, or they come without a card?
No, for example, they come without IDs. Maybe they have left them
somewhere.
Or they're caught up or somewhere or something, but they cannot allow them to access.
It's a bit hard. Maybe the language, but in terms of access, you will have to read
that one. We know
bears
it, the language,
because
I
it's hard.
I saw it and
it's
I was,
hard. But
I
if it is the language, that is something that I've noted.
Yeah.
And we will sensitize them.
Okay, all has been said. We'll stop here. That has been Sportswoman. My name is Becky Cynthia Nechmera. A good afternoon.
How was your weather?
Sportswoman is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.